we have to kind of wonder, how do these photographs sometimes follow and engage with tropes of colonial photography? Traditionally, in colonial photography, you would have a costume or one artifact that would symbolically signify the whole indigenous culture. And you can see that in quite a few of the postcards that are on display here. In addition, if you look at Macareti herself, she normally in daily life would have her hair tied up, but in all those photographs, she has her hair untied. And that very much engages with the tropes of the Polynesian woman being sexual or sexually available. If you take a look closer, you can also see quite a few pictures where you can see her arms or her ankles, which are supposed to also back this sort of trope. However, there are also signs in those different postcards that Macareti was very much in control of how she was represented. If you look at most of the photographs, she's actually looking back. She's not just submitted to the gaze of the white photographer, but she is looking back, she's gazing back at the onlooker. There are some very strong symbolic elements of power and of assertion in those photographs. So this portrait of Macareti is maybe one of the most famous portraits of her when she was still living in New Zealand. And you can see that she is wearing around her neck a Hei Tiki necklace, which is a very strong ancestral Maori symbol. And she also has on her hair a huia feather, which is a feather that would signify her own placement within a certain nobility in the Maori group. So in many ways, she challenges the idea that she is submitted to those photographs and to the expectations of the colonial gaze. So this kind of begs the question, how are those postcards different from anthropological photographs? And in what way are they actually the same? Because at the time, most anthropological and colonial photographs were very much staged, and Macareti in those postcards is actually regaining a sense of power and agency over the way she is being represented, although, of course, within the limited discourses of the time.